Markarov, what do you have to say about yourself? Or should I be more specific? The Vladimir. Vladimir. Here's Vladimir Markarov. What is it, a Markovka or a... Oh my gosh, Markovka, that means carrot in Russian, oh boy. Haven't played the Call of Duty game, but supposedly this is the guy from the No Russian kind of mission. So, Mr. Vladimir Markovka, what do you have to say about yourself? Yes, Mr. Carrot. You're not a carrot, are you? At least I hope not. Not like that Gideon with Persimmon. Now what is this? Markarov is a Markovka? Oh boy. This is not going to go well. Anyways, comrades, what does this Markovka have for us today? Well, he has this gun here, which I will remove for now. He comes with a suit. Yes, a Call of Duty figure with a suit. It's nice. He comes with the presidential slacks because those are the type of things people with suits like to wear. So, yeah, it makes sense. China print right here, which isn't a big bummer because it's not on the top, so doesn't get in the way that much. He comes with paint application right here, and if we take off his head, take off the vest, which comes with a flashbang, you get to see more detail on how the chest piece is done. Wait, there's a paint application right there. They just use a standard Call of Duty type of vest. Let me zoom in more closer. Yeah, nothing too unique except the paint application. For Markovka, this is the belt that they use. Swinging it around, they also managed to paint this part around, so yeah, it does a good job with the suit. And here's what the head mold looks like. I don't know about you, it kinda reminds me of the GTA 3 protagonist. Rather than Markovka, or Markarov, from the Call of Duty game, but whatever. I'll call him Markovka since I haven't played Call of Duty. Anyways, Mr. Markovka, he comes with gloves, like there. And this beard right here, not actually textured, it's just painted. Well, I guess you could say the paint does give it a little bit of texture, but yeah, it's not part of the mold. And also, no second eye application. But hey, at least it's not whole. And then the vest can slide on pretty easily. And as for the machine gun, yeah, it's pretty generic, not very special, but it's good. Okay, comrades, Mr. Markovka is going to get judged with the final judgment. For the aesthetics, I give this set an 8 out of 10. There's no second eye application, the suit's painted pretty nice, and it's a pretty good head mold. Other than that, I mean, it's pretty simple, it's just a one figure set, so. Moving on to the playability, I give this set a 7 out of 10. There aren't a lot of accessories to play with. Yes, the flash grenade can be attached with the peg system and everything, which you're already used to. The gun takes apart, of course, which does add the playability, but it's not, I mean, it's nothing special compared to other sets, which give us much more value, like that Arctic Ranger set that, oh my gosh, came with so many accessories. Guess what? Pretty lacking in the accessory department, but it's an in-game character, so that gives them more playability, because now you have the character to stage out those scenarios in which this Markovka character was involved in. Then for the value, I give the set a 7 out of 10. It's a named character, but it doesn't give you much value aside from that. Well, it's a unique head mold, and it's a tuxedo, so... Well, not tuxedo, suit, stupid. Tuxedo comes usually the tire. Whatever. It's a black suit, you make it whatever you want. However, this figure, what does create the value for is it's very massable. For if you want a lot of CIA operatives or some elite business people, whatever you want to do, here's the perfect thing. You want to just have a suit for a person to have a suit? There you go. Any formal scenario, whatever you do. And it's a pretty good head mold, you know. It's a pretty unique head mold. They haven't used this head mold anywhere else. Which I really think they should. Imagine we can get this head mold in yellow hair color or a different skin tone. Like, come on, Mega Constructs. Use these head molds and make even better figures. And last but not least, for the build, there isn't a build, so it's not applicable. And that brings us to our final score, which I give a 7.5 out of 10. It's a C. Well, my comrades, let's see what Mr. Markarov has to say about this. Or Mr. Markovka, what are you hiding today, Mr. Markovka? Or should I say in American, Mr. Carrot?
That's how stupid this is when I say it in American. See, in Russian when you say Mr. Markovka, it sounds so awesome. When you say it in American, Mr. Carrot, it just sounds so stupid. Anyways, comrades, I hope you enjoyed this video today.
If you did, be sure to give it a big fat juicy like. And as always, my comrades, if you want to see more content from me and friendly Porcupine, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button, I'll catch you in the next video. Take care, comrades. That was fast. Very fast.